And real images are always gonna be flipped, okay? Always. And you're always gonna have the object and image on the opposite side of the lens.
How our eyes work.
Oh, well, yes, but in this case, this is not an optical illusion. This happens regardless of the observer. I understand what you're saying, that your eyes flip the image on your retina,
yeah.
And then your brain flips it up again. Yeah, 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 yes. But okay, now I'm gonna do another example, and we're gonna create what are called virtual images. Okay. So I'm gonna try to do something very similar, same lens. So I have my focal point, I have my second focal point, and over here I'm going to have my lens. Now I'm going to place my object, and I'm going to place it and I'm gonna do exactly the same thing, okay? I'm gonna grab my three principal rays and I'm gonna apply the same restrictions and the same procedure that I have here. So first principal ray from the top of my object parallel to the optical axis. So parallel to the optical axis and it goes through the focal point. Okay, second principal ray is going to go through the center of the lens and it's going to continue going straight. So I'm going to have third one is going to go through the focal point, it's going to intersect the lens, and then it's going to go parallel. Okay? Now, I'm going to assume, oops, my lens is too short. they're gonna call it that. Okay? Now, in this case, we can see that they are not gonna converge anywhere on the image space. Okay, these rays are diverging and they're absolutely not converging at all. Okay, now, if I have an observer somewhere around here, that observer is gonna see these rays, and what do I assume is that these rays are coming from a source that is behind the lens, okay? So what I'm gonna do is, okay, I'm gonna keep propagating these lenses, like assuming that they're propagating in a straight line, and I'm gonna see if they intersect each other at some point. So this one, gonna come like this, this one, this one. Okay, so they intersect somewhere around there. Okay, so that's an image. Okay, and in this case, this is gonna be my image, okay? Again, this is the distance to the object, and this is gonna be the distance to the image. Now, in this case, the image is being formed on the object space. So my distance to the image, oh, I forgot, the distance to the image in this case is gonna be negative. Okay, I can calculate magnification the same way. I'm gonna use the same equation. So I can have magnification HI over HO. Now notice that the image and the object have positive heights. So this is 10. And this is 25. Okay. I can use the other equation. And this one is 20. And this one is 50. Now, the fact that we have magnification to be positive just means that the orientation of the image has the same orientation as the object, okay? And that's true of virtual images. The image always gonna have the same orientation as the object, and all of them are gonna be on the same side of the lens, okay? Now, how do we know when we have a virtual image or a real image? Real images can be projected on screens, okay? So the projector, when you see projecting an image on the screen, and we all can see that image, that's a real image, okay? When you go to the movies and everybody can see that image, that's a real image. You can put screens and then you can create those images. Virtual images, you need the eye of an observer to recreate this image. If you don't have this guy over here, it doesn't matter where you place the screen, you will never see that image. Your eye is a fundamental part of the optical system to recreate the image, okay? When do we have virtual images? in any optical instrument that you put into your eyes, you're gonna have virtual images. Telescopes, microscopes, binoculars. You put your eye, and you need to put your eyes in order to see the image, okay? If you are working with a microscope or a telescope, and you're like, oh, you should check this image, it's not like the guy can be, or your partner can be next to your microscope and see it. You need to replace positions, and then you put the eye, and then you can see the image. Lenses, they create virtual images, to the point that the lenses are tailored to your eye. But the image that you see, the image that we see with these lenses, is in front of us, which makes sense because that's what we want. We don't have an image that is formed between the lens and our eyes. Okay? Make sense? Now, how do we know in terms of an optical system when I'm gonna have virtual or real images? If your object is between the focal point and the lens, you're gonna have virtual images, always. If your object is to the left of the focal point, you're gonna have real images, always. Sorry, you're gonna have real images. This is assuming that you're working with biconvex, biconverging lenses. If you're working with a divergent lens, it doesn't matter where you put the object, you're always gonna have virtual images. So divergent lenses always produce virtual images. Okay, one of the main applications of virtual images in terms of optical instruments is to create an image that is far away from your eye, so your muscles relax and then you can use an optical instrument for a long time. Imagine that you are looking at an object that is very close to you. So in order to focus something very close, you need to stress your eye muscles. And after a long time, it gets tired and you can get a headache. So the way that you prevent that is to create a virtual image that's far away, and then your muscles relax, and then you can observe that thing for an extended period of time. That's what we want with many optical instruments. Okay. Make sense? Hey, Martea, how we doing?
Good to go.
Good to go? Well, yeah, that's it. That's all for today. You guys, I told you guys, we were a little bit